proceed further, we are going to have one class only for the problems, okay? But the problem is that in this chapter, there are many questions that combines multiple concepts together. So we can't have questions on single concept. Write down, principle of superposition. Or just write down superposition. This is the biggest topic of this chapter and the most important topic. If question from this chapter comes, 90% from this, 90% chance it will be from this topic. Okay? Now, superposition means what? It is like a collision. Okay, two mass when they collide, that situation you have discussed, momentum and all get conserved. But we have not yet learned what will happen if two waves collide. That is what we are going to learn. Okay, now when the two waves meet, there will be different things that will happen. And that makes this scenario very unique. When mass comes and hit the other mass, there is nothing other than force. Okay, so momentum gets conserved and you are able to write the momentum equation. But over here there will be multiple scenarios. Okay, so just first write down the scenarios. So if two waves, I am talking about superposition of two waves, because if you know how two waves superpose, after superposition you can superpose a third wave also. Okay, so 1 plus 2 is 1, then third one becomes the second one. So it is always two at a time. So two waves, white chalk, two waves traveling in same direction when meet, creates a third wave or creates another wave. That's a better wave.
So they combine or there are three waves in total?
They combine, huh? That's what two waves travel in the same direction when meet. Oh, you're talking about a third wave get generated. Only one wave get two waves they meet, and a third wave is the outcome of the two waves meeting. Two waves now gone. Second, two waves traveling in opposite direction having same wavelength and frequency create standing wave. Okay. Two waves having different frequencies.
Sir, what do you mean by a standing wave?
We are going to discuss it anyways. Just I give you a small example. Guitar play kiya kabhi?
Try.
Try to play. You might have tried playing guitar. That's a... So when you play the guitar, you'll see that this kind of wave will get generated. If you pluck the string, you'll see this kind of thing get generated when it vibrates, the string when it vibrates. Okay? This is also a wave. But what is happening is that these two points are fixed. One where the two ends where the string is held. Okay, this is wave which is not moving anywhere. What happens is one wave gets generated when you pluck it, then the wave get reflected from here, then this reflected wave travels in opposite direction, it meets the wave coming from this direction. When they meet, they create standing wave like this. We're going to discuss it in detail. Two waves having different frequencies, when they meet, can generate beats. This beat is not your song wala beat. I say 8 beat or 12.
How is it different from standing wave?
Which one?
Beats.
Beats is something else. I am going to show you actually. I'll play a video for this. Just write down three scenarios distinctly, because when we are going to take it one by one, you should not wonder that what is this, what is something new, okay? These are all the three scenarios that come up when two waves meet, okay? In the first two scenarios, I am assuming that frequency and the wavelength is same. In the third scenario, frequency is different. Okay? There is a fourth thing also, but that is not in the syllabus. So now you might have got an idea that two waves meeting is not as simple as two masses colliding. Okay? So according to superposition principle, y is equal to simply y1 plus y2. y1 and y2 are the wave equations of the two waves. Please write it down. According to superposition principle, y is equal to y1 plus y2. When the two waves meet, simply you have to take the algebraic sum of the two. I'm going to discuss it. Okay? Y1 is not A. Y1 is A sine kx minus omega t. Getting it? So when you add it, you have to add the sign. Fine. So according to superposition principle, there can be n number of ways. Y1 plus Y2 plus Y3 plus Y4, as I keep on adding it. Okay? So let's take Y1 as, write down in your textbook, they have taken cos or sign. Sometimes they take cos, sometimes they take sign. They have taken sign. Sine they have taken. Okay? A sine kx minus, when they talk about beats, they have taken it as cos. Y2 is equal to A sine kx minus omega t plus 5. They are the two ways. Can you describe what is the similarity of the two ways?
Velocity
is same. What else?
Amplitude
is same. Then?
Time period
is same. Wavelength, frequency, sab kuch same hai. What is the difference?
Phase
difference is there. Okay. I could have written here phi1 and this is phi2. Phi1, phi2, then phi2 minus phi1 will be the phase difference. So it is similar. Okay. Now please write down y1 plus y2 and tell me what equation you are getting. y1 plus y2. What you will get it as here? Use sine A plus sine B formula. Okay. y1 plus y2 will be 2a sine a plus b by 2, then cos a minus b by 2. So cos of
pi by 2.
This and sine of
kx minus omega.
Kx minus omega t plus pi by 2. Does it look like a wave? Does it look like a wave equation? Kyun nahi likh raha tumhe ye wave equation? This is your amplitude. If I, rather than this bracket, if I write capital A, suddenly it will look like a wave equation. Okay? So when two waves like this meet, it will create a third wave of what amplitude?
2a
cos of phi by 2. Okay? And when it comes to the wave, when we talk about the energy content in the wave, we talk about intensity. Intensity is a better representation of energy in terms of the wave, because there is a continuous transmission of energy. So it is better to talk in terms of power delivered per unit area. So intensity, do you know proportional to what? Amplitude square, do you know this?
Yeah.
You don't know. Now you know. Please write down intensity is proportional to amplitude square, assuming frequency constant. If you compare the two waves having the same frequency, intensity will be proportional to amplitude square. Okay? See the bed? Kya hai? Sit straight. Straight. Yes, sir. 90 degree. Not like this. That is more than 90. Come front little bit. Straight. Spine straight. Now we fly. Okay. So intensity is proportional to amplitude square if frequency is constant. If frequency is not constant, as in you are comparing two waves having different frequencies, then intensity is proportional to frequency square, amplitude square.
So intensity is power by time.
Power per unit area. Power is energy per unit time. Okay, fine. So here usually we are comparing the waves having the same frequency. So intensity is proportional to amplitude square. So initial intensity is some constant into a square. Final intensity is square of this 4a square cos square phi by 2. Yes or no? So can I say that intensity is equal to 4 times I naught cos square phi by 2? All of you understood this? Right? So intensity is 4 times the individual intensities multiplied by the cos square of phase difference by 2. Okay? Right? Now what is the maximum possible intensity? If I can change the phase difference, what is the maximum possible intensity? 4 I naught.
Sir, that k is equal to 1, right?
Where? No, k is not equal to 1. Intensity is, here also k will be there, right? Constant of proportionality.
Okay. So that's a there also.
No. The k into a square is I naught.
So both the k's should be
same. Both k's are same. Because frequency, wavelength, everything else is same.
Okay.
So I max is 4 I naught. What is the minimum value of intensity? Minimum is 0. Now this is something very unique. Very unique can't be together, right? There is something unique about the waves. So two waves can meet and they can destroy each other. Intensity will be gone. That doesn't happen when two masses can meet. It's like one wave, this, if this wave meets that wave, nothing is left. Fine, so it can happen. Similarly, one wave having intensity I naught meets the other wave having intensity I naught, and I naught and I naught creates 4 I naught. Okay, so basically what is happening is that the energy is getting concentrated and energy can become 0 also when they meet, in terms of when you talk about the waves. Now tell me, what should be the value of phi for which the maximum possible intensity comes? So for that, cos square phi by 2 should be 1. So cos of phi by 2 should be plus minus 1. So phi by 2 should be n pi. So phi should be equal to 2 n pi. So if phase difference between the two waves is 2 n pi, then you say that the maximum intensity will get generated. You also said constructive interference happens. This is for constructive interference between the two waves. Getting it? See, I'll just tell you the day-to-day life example of constructive and destructive indifference. Have you ever seen oil spilled on the surface of water? When you move past it, the color changes?
Yes, sir.
Color of the film changes?
Thing.
You don't know, you haven't
so
seen oil spilled on the water.
Thing.
Huh?
The weird rainbow thing.
Rainbow sort of thing where when you move past, the color continuously changes. And there's a location at that location become completely dark. And there's a location when you move past, suddenly it becomes very bright.
Okay.
So when it becomes suddenly bright, constructive difference is happening. When it has become completely dark, there's a destructive difference that is happening there. But there are many other examples that we'll be discussing later on, not now.
So this is for light.
This is for the light, and that is EM wave that you're going to learn in class 12th. Okay, so tell me, what is the value of phi for minimum intensity? Cos square phi by 2 should be equal to 0. So phi by 2 should be equal to what?
Phi plus 1 is pi by 2.
2n plus 1 times pi by 2. So the value of phi should be 2n plus 1 pi. So if it is an odd multiple of pi, destructive interference happens. An even multiple of pi, constructive interference happens. Understood? Any doubts? Keep it to yourself. Any puja 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 puja. No doubts. See, this phase difference determines everything. Because the only difference between the two waves is phase difference. Everything else is same.
So what if everything else was different?
Now that is, I mean, slowly and slowly we'll do it. Now I'll change the amplitude. Okay, is this clear to all of you?
Everything is different, do they interact? Yeah,
they'll interact? No, why not? If you force them to interact, they will interact. What to do? Right? If I force you to interact with him, even though you don't like him, you'll talk, right? I hate you. He loves me, okay, I hate you. That is the kind of interaction you'll have. Right? So, see, right now also in this room, there are multiple waves. Light is coming from here, here, everywhere else light is coming. But the problem is that these light sources, they are not having same phase difference. When K and omega are different, the difference between these two phases change with time. Yes or no? When you do cos A minus B by 2, Kx minus omega T disappears. When you do cos A minus B by 2, omega 1 and omega T both will be there, K1 and K2 will also be there. So with time, the amplitude changes. And the frequency of change is very fast, 50 times in a second. So you can't see it. You can see only when the phase difference between the two waves is constant. So that is why we are studying this.
So can EM waves interact with mechanical?
No, both are not. It's like aliens interacting with humans. Good question. EM wave interacting with mechanical waves. EM wave can generate momentum and it can transfer energy. So yeah, in that way some interaction is possible, but that is
unnecessary. So if you pass the energy to something, it will be interaction.
So what will it do? So
if you change the temperature, then
EM waves. But I'm not talking about that kind of interaction. We are talking about this kind of interaction here. Okay, there will not be interference between EM wave and mechanical wave. Okay. By the way, since he has pointed out that velocity we have found out for the sound is gamma p by rho, right? And p is equal to rho rt by m. You know this or not? So P by rho is RT by M. So gamma RT by M is also the speed of sound. So velocity can be written as root of gamma RT by M. And hence velocity is proportional to root over temperature of the air.